Friends, let us continue the problems on unit 1. I have selected next the fifth problem. It goes like this: steam at 18 bar. Steam at 18 bar. Pressure is 18 bar. And dryness fraction 0.9. Is heated at constant pressure. So the process is constant pressure process, is heated at constant pressure until it is dry and saturated. So x2 is 1, x1 is 0.9, x2 is 1. Find the increase in volume delta V. Delta V is how much? And increase in volume and work done per kg of steam, that is mass is 1 kg, mass of steam is 1 kg. If the volume is now kept constant, find out how much heat is to be extracted to reduce the pressure to 14 bar. Now for this process, volume is constant. It is constant volume process. So there are two processes here. One is constant pressure and the other one is constant volume process. Now first we'll do this. Now delta V means change in volume, V2 minus V1. V2 will be, because this is this thing, X2 into, this will be same as VG2. VG2, here P1 is equal to P2, so even if you don't put this, it is VG only. Next, V1 is X1 VG. So for that pressure, given pressure, what is the pressure? Pressure is 18 bar. For 18 bar, from the steam table, the pressure 18 bar, the volume is, VG is 0.1104 cubic meters per kg. This is the volume of 1 kg of steam. Now this will remain the same. So 0.9 into 0.1104. So this will be 0.9 into 0.1104. 0.09936 cubic meters per kg. Now delta V will be V2 minus V1, that is0.09936 will give me 0.01104. cubic meters per kg. Now work done will be equal to 100 P into delta V, change in volume. So 100 into 18 into 0.01104. So that is the answer is here, into 100 into 18. This works out to 19.87 kilojoules per kg. Work done during that process. He wants what? He wants work done only. he wants heat supplied also. Q will be H2 minus H1, constant pressure process. So H2 minus H1. So H2 will be Hg, Hg, H1 will be Hf plus X, Hfg. Hg is corresponding to 18 bar, Hg is 2797 kilojoules per kg. H1 is Hf is 885 plus 0.9 into Hfg is 1912. That works out to 885 plus 0.9 multiplied by 1912. That gives me 2605.8 kilojoules per kg. This is H1. So Q will be H2 minus H1. That is 2797 minus 2605.8. 2797 minus answer. 191.2 kilojoules per kg. This is the quantity of heat supplied. Heat supplied. Q. Now, next. Next is constant volume process. So, second one. Volume is constant now. P1 is 18 bar. X1 is 1. That is, we have brought it to dry saturated condition. Now P2 is given as 14 bar. He is asking what is the heat to be rejected. What is Q? Now we have to find out Q. So this is constant volume process. So Q will be U2 minus U1. U1 you have to find out for this condition. You have to find U1. For this condition we have to find U2. Now to find U2, we don't know the condition of steam. We know only the pressure. So X2 we have to find out. X2 will be equal to X1 VG1 divided by VG2. X1 is 1, VG1 for 18 bar, for 18 bar VG is 0.1104 divided by VG2 for 14 bar. It is 0.1408. So 0.1104 divided by 0.1408 will give me 0.78. This is the drainage fraction. So U1 will be HG1 minus 100 P1 VG1, because it is dry here. It is dry saturated. So this will be the formula. So U1 will be HG1 for 18 bar. For 18 bar HG1 is 2797. Minus 100 into 18 into VG1 is 0.1104. So that gives me 2797 minus 100 into 18 into 0.1104 will give me 2598.3 roughly kilojoules per kg. U2 for this condition, now it is wet, so it will be HF2 plus X2 HFG2 minus 100 P2 X2 VG2. HF2 for 14 bar, HF is 830 plus X2 is 0.78 into HFG2, HFG2 is 1960 minus 100 into 14 into 0.78 into VG2 is 0.14 1498.
So now 830 plus 0.78 into
1960 minus 100 into 14 into 0.78 into 0.1408 equals 2205 kilojoules per kg roughly. So now he wants delta U will be U2 minus U1, that is 2205 minus 2598.3 that gives you minus 393.something kilojoules per kg. This negative sign means this is delta U. Q is also same as delta U, that is minus 393.something. So many kilojoules per kg. That means so much heat is lost by the steam when its condition is changed from this to this. It has lost 1 kg of steam, loses that quantity of heat. Next, friends, I'll take up problem number 9 from the question bank. Problem number 9, which is like this. Analyze the condition of steam in each of the following cases. Number 1, at a pressure of 10 bar, and temperature 200 degree centigrade. Second, at a pressure of 8 bar, and its volume is 0.22 cubic meter per kg, Third, at a pressure of third, at a pressure of at a pressure of 12 bar, and its enthalpy is 2688 kilojoules per kg. Its enthalpy is 2688 kilojoules per kg. This in this problem he has given three samples of steam. He has given pressure in all of them, pressure and another one property is given. We have to tell what type of steam it is, whether it is wet, dry, superheated, or what type of steam it is. So now I'll take the first one. In the first case, he has given the pressure as 10 bar. So take 10 bar and see what is this saturation temperature. For 10 bar, when the pressure is 10 bar, from the steam table, saturation temperature is 179.9 degree centigrade. Now, the given steam is at the same pressure, but its temperature is higher than 179.9. So, you have to write, because the temperature of given steam is, from steam table, this is the value of Tsat for this pressure. Now, you have to write, because the given steam has higher temperature, that is 200 degree centigrade, higher than that temperature at the same pressure, therefore this steam is superheated steam, you have to write. Then you have to write T soup is equal to 200 degree centigrade. So degree of superheat is equal to T soup minus T sat. That is 200 minus 179.9. So that means it is 20.1 degree centigrade above its saturation temperature. That is the meaning of telling degree of superheat is 20.1 degree centigrade, means its temperature is 20.1 degree centigrade above the saturation temperature. Second case, this is the pressure, this is the volume. You have to write from the steam table, for pressure of 8 bar, the value of Vg is, for 8 bar, the value of Vg is 0.2403 cubic meter per kg. Now, this has, if you compare this, this has lesser volume than that. So, if it is lesser volume than that, then the steam is wet steam. There it was superheated steam, here it is wet steam. Now, X will be equal to V divided by Vg, that is given volume divided by Vg, that is 0.22 divided by 0.2403. So, 0.2403, so 0.22 divided by 0.2403 will give me 0.915. This is the dryness fraction of that. If you say it is wet steam, you have to give what is its dryness fraction. Third case, what we have to do is, from steam table, for a pressure of 12 bar, what is Hg? Hg is 12 bar, for 12 bar, Hg is 2784 kilojoules per kg. That means, if it has this much of enthalpy, then it is dry steam. It has lesser enthalpy than that, so it is wet steam. So you have to write, because the enthalpy of given steam is lesser than that at the same pressure, it is wet steam. When you say it is wet steam, you have to give its dryness fraction. So for giving dryness fraction, you know, H is equal to HF plus X HFG. So we have to find out this X. X will be equal to H minus HF. This HF, if it comes this side, it becomes minus whole thing divided by HFG. So you have to find out for 12 bar what is HF and what are these values. So for 12 bar, HF is 798 kilojoules per kg from steam table. HFG is 1986 kilojoule per kg. So these values have to be substituted here. So X is equal to H. H means 2688 minus 798 or divided by 1986. So 2688. 2688 minus 798 equals divided by 1986 equals 0.95, you get 166 something. So if you write that much, that is enough. This is the dryness fraction of the steam here. So here it is superheated, here it is wet, here also it is wet. If you say it is superheated, you have to find the degree of superheat. If you say it is wet, you have to give the dryness fraction of the steam. Next, we will take, let's continue the numericals. Next, I have selected the 15th problem. The internal energy of 1 kg of steam, at a pressure of 14 bar, is 2420 kilojoules. Calculate the dryness fraction of this steam. If the internal energy of 1 kg of steam at a pressure of 14 bar is this much, what is its dryness fraction? Find the increase in internal energy, delta U, if this steam is superheated at constant pressure. That means pressure will be 14 bar only. It is superheated to 295 degrees centigrade. Pressure remaining constant and Cp is given as 2.3 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. So for this condition, what is the increase in internal energy? Now, first we'll do this. Now here he has asked what is the dryness fraction. That means it is wet steam. You know V, U wet is equal to HF plus X HFG minus 100 PXVG. This is the formula. So from this we have to find out the value of X. Now I am not using 1, 2 because here pressure doesn't change, the pressure remains the same. So I have just taken as HF, HFG like that. I have not used 1, 2 like that, subtitles I have not used. The pressure is 14 bar. So for 14 bar, HF is 830 This is known, 2420, this is known. HF is 830 plus X, I don't know, into HFG is 1960 minus 100, P is 14, X I don't know, VG is 0.1408, these are the values. Now these two cannot be added because they are unlike. So 2420 minus 830, this must be taken this side, is equal to 1960x minus, that works out to 100 into 14 into 0.1408, that works out to 197.1x. So this will be 2420 minus 830 equals 1590 is equal to, this will be 1960 minus 197.1 equals 1762.9.9x. So x is equal to 1590 divided by 1762.9 1590 divided by answer will give me 0.9. So this is the Drenner's fraction. I got this. I got X. If this is the internal energy of 1 kg of steam at this pressure, then its Drenner's fraction must be 0.9. Now, this is U1, actually U1. Now what you have to do for this condition, the pressure is same. Now it is superheated. Find out what is its internal energy now. Next, U2 minus U1 will give you the increase in internal energy or change in internal energy. So, for finding U2, the formula to be used is, for U2, the formula to be used is Hg plus Cp into T sup minus T sat minus 100 P Vg into capital T sup divided by capital T sat. Hg, again for 14 bar only I have to find out. I have to find out for 14 bar. Hg for 14 bar is 2790. 2790 plus, this is given as 2.3, T sup is 295, T sat for 14 bar is 195 minus 100 into 14, VG remains the same, 0.1408 into T sup, 295 plus 273, that is 568 divided by, this is 468 T sat 100. So now 2790 plus this, subtract first, it will be 100. So 230 minus 100 into 14 into 0.1408 into 568 divided by 468 equals 239.2 plus 2790 plus 230 minus 239.2 will give me 2780.8 kilojoules per kg. This is U2. Now, increase in internal energy will be U2 minus U1. This is 2780.8 minus 2420. That gives me 360.8 kilojoules per kg. So this is how it should be done. Okay, this is increase in internal energy. I hope you have understood it. You please like, share, comment and subscribe the channel.